We'll get onto Twitter now. So if you are on your Twitter, please follow us. So if you want to follow at local, like I said, ExaPerth would be if you want to see how to local reach. ExaWeb is our national address. It's different in terms of when to post, time frame wise, when it comes to Twitter. So in terms of Twitter, the best time, Monday to Thursday, is 1 to 3 p.m. And obviously your worst time is every day after 8 p.m. So people use those sort of mediums in different ways. People tend to use Facebook a lot more out of work time. Actually, an article I read last year was that ACT was the Twitter capital of Australia because of all the politicians using Twitter. So with Twitter, what you want to do is you want to promote your username where you can. You want to sync your email contacts with Twitter. These are ways that you can build your followers. I will have some secret tips on how to do it and how we increase ours. You also want to make sure that with every social media you have, add it to all of your email signatures so that people can easily click on the bottom of your email and connect with you. Does everyone know what QR codes are? Yeah, so we've got our QR code. It's not as used in Australia. It's mainly, like, when I've gone to New York, China, it's mainly used over there, but sometimes having something a little bit different might get people to try and scan it. I'm interested to see whether it will take off a lot more in Australia. Probably not. This is an example of a boosted tweet where they're actually used advertising. So some of the things that are used is obviously hashtags, win, even the promotion of the actual of boosted post. I want to give you this example because we thought, a boring photo above our staff won't go very far. But we posted an interesting question. So we posed this picture of our staff in WA. So what's the plural of selfie? Is it groupie or ussie? And then, we got all these people on Twitter like responding and, we think it's this, we think it's that. So it was just a good way to pose the question. That's what I mean by posing a question. And also by using hashtags. So we use like selfie hashtag and that when we reposted it to Twitter and they worked pretty well. So just a good example.
So what was your research? Rand said, it's weird.
Surely it would be selfless was the first one. Then the other guy said wheelies. Selfless has better ring to it. Gen Y and Gen X probably selfless. Or youthies.
Youthies. Baby boomers with youthies.
But yeah, so if you pose an interesting question, then especially around something like that, then probably you get a bit more engagement. Okay, so Twitter with hashtags. So the hashtag was actually came from Twitter originally, but it's more prominent in Instagram. If you're using more than two hashtags, drops engagement by 17%. But I do have some stats on exactly what to use with Twitter. You definitely, people are more likely to retweet when there's at least one hashtag included. And 25% of tweets without hashtags do get retweeted. We'll go through hashtagging a little bit more. In terms of Twitter secrets, how to get more followers, definitely the thing that most people don't tell you is you want to see who is following other businesses or people of interest in your area. So for example, if I wanted to get more Perth followers, I might follow the followers of a Perth magazine or a Perth radio station, or I want to be quite specific to the local area. So in the same way, you want to follow people that are interested in your area. They're not interested in your area and they're from a different country, then it might not be relevant for you, and you want followers that actually want to engage with you. And the other thing is if you use shout-outs and you actually speak to your people and engage with what they're posting and seeing what they're posting, you'll get more engagement. And try to link with big brands. So one of the examples I used here was Nando's. We just decided to muck around with Twitter and Facebook and see how far we could go with it. So there was International Hot and Spicy Day, so we tweeted at Nando's and said, look at us, we're enjoying, spicy food on International Spicy Day. And then Nando's responded, at ExaPerth, you guys are crazy over there, contact us and I can hook you up with some free sauce. So just find the fun ways to maybe connect with local businesses and just to stretch the message a bit further. This one over here was interesting. Again, we're trying to see whether we could do some funny memes and because we could be a little bit more fun because we're in the digital space. So we did 101 uses for the Yellow Pages book. So, when I was sleeping, this one's a hat. We actually had Yellow Pages engage with our post and they said, experimenting with fashion is a great thing, but it looks like your staff need a bit of help in the hat department. Here's some hats to all these things in Perth. So just another way to engage a little bit of fun level without being rude. So the top tips for Twitter is frequency, definitely. You need to update it multiple times. You need to respond to comments because if you don't have fun and people want to respond, then you don't go anywhere with it. You really need to be a bit more active with responding. Like I said, with the character limit, you don't want to use it all because you want people to be able to retweet and add their comments. And you want to use mixed media. You want to be careful. If you try and follow too many people in a day, I think we found it was 100 before we got banned, then you actually will get blocked. So you don't want to follow over 100 people on Twitter per day, otherwise you get blocked. and you want to keep it positive, trolls and negativity will lose followers, but if you're fun with it, then people will like it, retweet it, and post it everywhere, and you want to be appropriate. No one really cares what, you know, CEO had for breakfast. You want to keep it fun and interesting and engaging, and you want to use your logo and your brand in your picture to make it a lot stronger. Someone had a question that they texted me regarding social media and Google. There definitely is a correlation. So Twitter in particular, LinkedIn, Google Plus, sometimes if you write something in there, they'll actually come up in searches. So there is a connection where tweets will actually now be visible in Google search. So definitely something to keep in mind with how you write your social media, because it can come up in Google search. The other day I was searching for a service and someone's LinkedIn profile came up. So definitely there's a strong correlation between Google and social media. Just some examples of some of the fun tweets we've done. We did a seminar, and just to go with what was trending at the moment, 50 Shades of Grey just come out, so we did grey hair, and just to see how much reach we could get. I do a marketing breakfast, a lot of government people attend, there's three marketing managers from local government that attend the marketing breakfast in WA. So just putting that out there and people sharing sort of what we learned and what we talk about in the marketing breakfast. Just pictures of the team, even videos, which we'll talk about shortly, regarding engagement, case studies, testimonials, and just having a bit of fun with it. Some of the ways that people use their social media, so for example, Kevin Rudd, he signs off as K-Rudd, so you're just having a bit more personality in the way that you engage. Same with Julia Gillard. I like this one here because they have an amazing cover photo. So you live in some really beautiful councils, and you can put something really amazing out, they get some really good shots. That's what can give you a bit more attention, but like I said, you want to have your strong logo here, and you want to have that cover image really showing something special or engaging about your place.